All right, Shalom. I want to give all praises to Yahawah, BaHaSham, Yahawashi, BaHaSham, Rawchaa, Qadash. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the Lord's hopeful elect scattered abroad, teaching his word in sincerity and truth. Shalom. All right, so you see the title and you see these two knuckleheads, these two guys, you know, bunch of niggas. All right, you know, this is a prime example. You know, and what, you know, us here, starting with the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, we tell you that, you know, just because you know that you're an Israelite does not mean you're going to be saved. Okay? You know, you got niggas, you know, out of the hoods, out of the ghettos, you know, they want to become teachers and prophets, you know. Not saying that some are not, you know, some are, you know, some will be, you know. All of us comes from different walks and ways of life. But my point is that you got guys with pride and not willing to put off the old man. You know, that's why it's not good to promote, you know, rap music. It's not good to promote bow and arrows and guns and going to get your rifle and your staff and your, look, man, your strap and all that bullshit, hood shit. I pray the Lord just kill that shit, man. And every last one of you guys that promote that shit, because all that is a gimmick to pull these niggas out the ghetto, man. Pull these niggas out the hood. Pull these niggas out the sewers. All right. And I say that because what really brought me to this video was the brother Kalab the cook, you know, GMS Chief Cornerstone, brother in the camp. He did a response to this video, all right? And he got the video from Elder Apostle Gabar's page. And he said in his video to go to the page and go down to the comment board. These guys left a link. So,
did you ever look up the...
This is Elder Apostle Gabar's page. And this is the video, Shunned. And if you go down, there these guys go. There's his link. And before I clicked the link, I saw that Apostle Gabar, he responded. So, you know, his response was, now normally I will remove this comment, but I want all to see the rotten underbelly side of this truth. I want all to see a couple of magpies with no understanding, a couple of sewer rats spluing vomit. And that's clearly the truth, man. I agree with Elder Apostle Gabar 100%. You know, this is a prime example, all right, of niggas knowing that they Israelites. And why I'm calling them niggas, because you can clearly see they haven't put off the old man. There's a certain class, you know, this is a certain manner in how you conduct yourself when you read in these scriptures. Because, you know, this word is not of us, it's of the Lord. The Lord is using us as vessels. That's all we are. That's all we are. It's just vessels being used by the Lord in righteousness to speak. That's it. So for all the pride, the fame, you know, you're looking for attention, because that's what this is, man. This guy didn't leave no comment. I have never seen his channel before. And he just leaves a link. You know, you got guys coming out of the sewers and they want to be seen. And that just proves that we're more closer to the end than we ever was before. And I mean the end of Esau. I mean the end of this society. We're approaching Jacob's trouble soon, man. Sooner or later, it's going to be Jacob's trouble. Okay? Sooner or later, there will be a famine of this word. All right? It's going to be a famine of this word. You're not going to be able to watch a video and learn the lessons that's being taught. The ones you may probably see at those times when the famine of the word is probably these scoffers, probably these knuckleheads, man. All right. You know, and I just want to say for you newly fruit out there, you know, the hopeful elect that's just coming around, watch Great Millstone videos and learn and get the knowledge, you know, get it for yourself. Don't get it because you want to be a part and want to look like something. You know, if you want to look like something, be like something, be like Yahawashi, man. Okay? And learn the knowledge. Because the scriptures say that knowledge and wisdom shall be the stability of thy times. That's what's going to get you saved, man. Having this knowledge, okay? Having this wisdom. It's going to keep you stable in the time of Jacob's trouble. It's going to keep you stable in the very end, okay? If the Lord's willing, all right? If the Lord deemed you as the elect, you know, that's what this thing is about, man. It's not about trying to be I want to be my own leader, you know? You know, and I want to be a top teacher. I need to know all the breakdowns. Matter of fact, y'all's wrong, mine's right. But instead, you only known of this truth by watching the teachers, watching the prophets. You know, which clearly you're going to see in this video. And I don't want to make it too long. I just want to hit the points. But by playing this video, this dude is way the fuck off, man. Look at these dudes, man. He got his head covered and his man's to the left with the Steelers jacket. He look like he don't even want to read that shit. Excuse me, not shit. He look like he don't even want to read the scriptures. And that's just my observation of watching his persona and spirit. You know? Stop trying to climb up some other way. You got niggas out here, man, that's watching brothers and they knowing a little something, something. Let me say this because it came to mind. It was a woman, which is a fucking demon. I pray every day the Lord destroy, right? I was with this woman, and she told me, you know, she told me on her block, and she stayed one of these badass blocks, dirty blocks, man. And she told me that on her block, she said, you know, she let me hear it too, because she recorded them. You know, niggas on the porch, you know how niggas do. They all deep on the porch, smoking, drinking, listening to music. Got the fucking Jake something else, boy. He bring the fucking speakers, the radio all on the in the front of the porch, and it's like a party on the block, like a block party, you know. But anyway, they was, you know, arguing. You know, this dude's about to fight. One dude was about to get shot because he was arguing with another guy about being a Hebrew Israelite. One guy believed that he was, and another guy believed he was Muslim. And one guy, you know, he came up and said, kill all that Israelite shit, I'll shoot you, or some shit like that, you know. So, you know, later on, so happened, I was around, happened to be on that block, you know, in the car, chatting with her, and the Lord revealed it, you know, right from my ears to hear. These guys was at it again. You know, I heard it through the car window. You know, these guys up there arguing about being an Israelite, him being a Muslim again. Now, these are niggas, man. Hood niggas. All right. You know, one part of me was, you know, wanted to correct them. Then the other part of me, which was wisdom, it was saying to me, let the filthy stay filthy. Let the righteous be righteous. And, you know, of course, I chose wisdom. You know, I just, you know what? I hurry up and got the fuck up off that block. But yeah, man, hey, you know, since this summer, I've been realizing here over here in Newark, New Jersey. All right. I've been realizing it's been a lot of hood niggas that agree that they Hebrew Israelites, but these guys got pride and they're not willing to put off the old man. All right. And this just reminds me of it straight up, you know. So with that being said, let's play some of this video.
Read what you got, bro.
This is verse 7.
Read verse 6 again.
This is verse 6. The words of the Lord are pure words, as silver tried in a furnace of earth, purified 7 times.
Yeah, man. And that 7 mean complete, man. All right.
Now, first off, he said the word 7 means complete. Now, where did you get that from? All right. Because the number 7, you know, is meaning complete, is not doctrine, is not written in the scriptures that it says that. All right. You know, this comes from our apostles and elders, you know, and basically those of One West. All right. Because the numbers, that's not written in the scriptures, but we do use it because it's a form of understanding. OK, 7 represents complete. 3 means understanding. 6, I think, is beauty. 10 is kingdom, you know, but that's not doctrine. That's not what you call it, written in the scriptures. This is something brothers use, all right, because it's spiritual. And it's on point, though. It's on point. But my thing is, where did he get that from? to say that seven represents complete. You got this from watching men, the men of the Lord. All right. So how are you up here telling us that the RFID microchip is not the mark of the beast, when brothers done broke down this mark of the beast so much? Excuse me. Brothers done broke down the mark of the beast. How can you not see it? And clearly, as I played a video, you could clearly see he did not do any type of research on the chip. This is just pride and seeking attention. All right.
Seven times. So, you know, these articles, man, all these.
And by the way, anywhere, I see that his channel name is Teachers of Truth. It's really Teachers of Lies. And then when you look to the left, you see the depicted image of Yahawah, Yahawashi. Okay. And where did he get that from? All right. This goes back to One West. This goes back to what? Our teachers, man. Okay. So it shows you that this guy, you know, he watched men of the Lord scriptures and he took bits and parts, and now he wants to, you know, put his thing on it. You know, this is, when we teach this word, it is not of us, man. It's not of men. Okay. Like the scriptures were written by man, but it was inspired by the Most High. All right. This word of ours, this doctrine, the precepts, the breakdowns, it's really of Yahawah, BaHaSham, Yahawashi. The Lord gave us a way in order to how to understand the times in which we live in it, man. You know.
That you guys teaching this mark of the beast madness, man. All right, you guys bugging, bro. All right, let's go into it. Get the Revelations, chapter 13, verse 15. All right, you guys bugging, man. All right, 13.
No, nigga, you bugging. What are you talking about?
16. Telling brothers they gotta have they can't have their head covered, man.
This
all
is
right.
Revelations.
Hold on, man. We just read, man, straight out the book, man. In the book of Samuel, man, David and all the men that was with him had their head covered, man.
Pause. What the hell he talking about? Is there another video before this video? Because you did not just read David and his men had their head covered. What you read was Psalms 12 and 6, and I'll read it. It says, the words of the Lord are pure words, as silver tried in the furnace of earth, purified seven times. That's all you read. All right. That's all you read. So what you talking about? You just read out the book. And he's talking about, we saying that you can't prophesize with your head covered. We didn't make that up. That's scripture. That's scripture. So I'm going to get the scripture, but I want him to finish.
All right. The head that you don't supposed to cover is Yahawashi, man. That's what it's referring to in 1 Corinthians, bro. All right? I advise you, brothers, to look up that word head, man.
It's all right. Okay. He advised. All right. So let's go read 1 Corinthians 11 and 1. This is Paul. Be ye followers of me, even as I also am of Yahawashi, Mashiach. Now I praise you, brethren, that ye remember me in all things and keep the ordinances as I delivered them to you. So this right there in the second verse, the key word there is ordinances, because this is what Paul's getting into, which ordinances goes into what? Order. All right. So he's saying keep the order as he gave it. You know, don't change up nothing. OK, so let's see what order says, what the blue letter says.
Strong's G 3862. Paradosis. Paradosis.
All right. It says giving up. Giving over, the act of giving up, the surrender of cities, a giving over, which is done by word or mouth. A giving over, which is done by word of mouth or in writing, tradition, by instructions, narrative, precepts, etc. All right. So order is instructions, man. It's instructions. When somebody says keep the ordinances, is meaning keep the order, keep the tradition of instructions, keep these instructions, man. Let me see. Objectively, that which is delivered. Yeah, objectively, that which is delivered, the substance of a teaching. of the body of precepts, etc., ritual, which is an opinion, right? Okay, yeah, tradition, ordinance. So order, ordinance represents order. Okay, that's all it means. And I just wanted to emphasize on that, because that's what Paul's getting into. Because this guy clearly, you know, he's not in order. He don't even understand what he's reading. You know, he don't have no order. If he had order, he would be more humble. You know, he would follow the teachings in which he was taught, and he would do his own research. It don't mean you got to just follow somebody because they said it. Do your own research, you know, but the Lord ain't dealing with this guy. So anyway, verse 3, but I will have you know that the head of every man is Yahawashi. So here's the order. Yahawashi is the head of every man, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Yahawashi, Hamashiach, is Yahawah. Okay, so that was the order. Now, verse 4, every man praying or prophesizing, talking about the prophets, okay, talking about the Israelites, if you're praying to the Lord, and if you're a prophet and you're prophesizing to the Lord, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head. So what the hell is this guy talking about? It's talking about your physical head. It's talking about, you know, you know, the Lord doesn't want to see an Israelite man prophesizing or praying to him with his head covered. And then it says for women, for verse 5, but every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered dishonoreth her head, for that is even all one as if she were shaven. All right. Because now you got, don't get simple. You got, women ain't no prophets. But if a woman have a dream or so, hey, a woman's supposed to cover her head up. You know, if a woman was amongst men and these men were teaching, she's supposed to have her head covered because the scriptures are coming out. All right. Doesn't mean that a woman is a prophet. Just wanted to make that statement because people get so simple, man. All right. You know, even children could prophesize. All right. They have a dream or a spirit come upon them and they want to speak something. That's prophesizing. All right. You're saying things that the word prophet just means to say before. All right. You're just saying things before it happened. That's all it is. Don't mean you're a psychic. The Lord used you as a vessel to say something. That's all it is. That's all it is. All right. But anyway, back to this guy. What is he talking about? You know, it's to show you that these guys is sewers, man. They're coming right out of the sewers, man. You know?
Head that you don't supposed to cover is Yahawashi, man. That's what it's referring to in 1 Corinthians, bro.
Wrong, wrong, wrong.
Oh, all right. I advise you, brothers, to look up that word head, man.
Okay, the word head. That's what he said. So let's go look up the word head. See what he's talking about. All right, his head, all right, head. It says the head, both of men and often of animals. Exactly, it's talking about your physical head. Since the loss of the head destroys life, this word is used in the phrase relating to the capital and extreme punishment. Anything supreme, chief, person, masters, lord of head, husband, relations. Yeah, it says what? The physical head, the head both of men and often of animals. That's the physical head. But then it also can metaphorically speak of somebody over you. But we understand the over you already when you go read the scripture. Paul set it up beautiful. Verse 3, but I will have you know that the head of every man is Yahawashi. Okay, that head right there is talking about the Lord. Okay, using it metaphorically as over us. That's that head he's talking about. And the head of the woman is the man. All right, because the man is over the woman. That's how the Lord set it up. And the head of Yahawashi is the Most High. So that's in order. The Father, the Son, the Israelite man, then the woman. Right. Then it says, every man praying or prophesizing, having his head covered, dishonor of his head. He's talking about what man, okay, who is the flesh? Okay, the man is flesh. If he's praying to the Lord and if he's prophesizing, having his head covered, his physical head covered, dishonor of his head. That's not what we said. That's what the scriptures say. So he's trying to confuse you with head metaphorically and head, which represents the body of, you know, the head of the body, you know, which is above your neck, you know, or atop of your shoulders. You're trying to confuse people, man. Hey, see, shit like that get people stumbled, man. So you trying to stumble the Lord's elect, man. You know, you trying to stumble to one of the Lord's looted ones. And that's a penalty of death. Matter of fact, the scriptures say, I'll quote, you shall wrap a millstone around your head and toss yourself in the sea, man. You know, for trying to stumble one of the Lord's looted ones, man. You know, hey, this truth is serious, man. You guys making this video, this is not some YouTube thing, man. This is real. You dealing with spirits, man. You dealing with some real top of the line. I don't know how to say it right, if I'm saying it right. But you dealing with spirits, man. You dealing with some spirits that would kill you, man. You dealing with the Lord, man. Okay, the Most High could send forth demons upon you, which he already have. But he can plague your mind even more, man. You trying to break down what the Lord have built. The scriptures say, if you don't gather, you scattereth. It's always these guys. Where these guys coming from at the very end? We got Esau to deal with. And then you got Israelites that's coming out of nowhere. You got this other guy, Qadash, from Phopi. You know, he talking about the tribes are all Negroes. We in 2019, this guy talking about this. Then I seen a video. He said that he had a brother in GMS that agreed with him. And he can't stop. He got to keep it going because he got to get our people out of this madness. You trying to tear down what the Lord built. Get your wicked ass out of here. You know, you got these guys. The other group, I saw Elder Apostle Gabon, Elder Apostle Tahar do. They respond to these guys saying that I think the tribes of Israel are natives or Latinos, something of that nature. Man, this shit crazy, man. But it is what it is, man. You know? So we do these videos to hope to edify the Lord's elect. You know, I ain't even going to let this keep going on. I think this is long enough. And hopefully you edified and stay strong and keep your feet shrouded in this truth, man. You know, and keep walking the path of righteousness. Don't be like the rest of these niggas, man. Let me just play a little bit.
It says authority, man. Go ahead and read what you got, bro.
And this is Revelations
13:16.
Chapter 13, verse 16.
Yeah.
And he causeth all, both small and great, and rich and poor.
And then he is referring to the beast, man. Babylon, man. All right. Basically, the so-called white man, man.
Man, it's just Esau. The hell you talking about, man? Babylon, because the chip is going to be around all the world. It's happening right now. He is Esau, man. Okay. His agenda, you know, he got these other nations even pushing forth. You got China, all right? You got Sweden. You got East India. All of these places, these people are being microchipped. Their society have changed, you know?
Mike, all right? Read from the top again, bro.
And he causes all, both and great.
Both small and great. Go ahead.
Rich and poor. Free and bond. To receive a mark.
To receive a mark, man. Now, according to these guys' madness, man, that they teach, that mark is referring to the RFID microchip that's going to be inserted in your hand, man.
All right, now he told us, he advised us to go look up the word head in 1 Corinthians. I'll advise you to go look up the word mark in Revelations. All right, go look up the word mark in what you're reading then, since you advised us to go look up the word head.
In your forehead, man, which that's madness, because the scriptures don't say that, man. He said he causes all, both small, great, rich, and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark, and that mark is referring to money, man.
Do this guy not know that the chip, it's a new form of currency? Do this guy not know? Yo, I really believe these guys, when they see videos and brothers edify and they put videos out there with the chip, you know, guys getting implanted and new tech coming up, you know, and like devices and all this. These guys, they don't click on the video because they don't want to see it. They don't really want to see that the chip, because they don't want to believe it. They don't want to see that the chip is the mark of the beast. You know, I really believe these guys, they will not click on that video, yo. They probably be like, oh, I ain't clicking on that. Because if this guy had any understanding, he said money, the chip is a form of money. It's a new form of currency. It's digital currency. This is what the elite's agenda, in which they changed it from Agenda 21 to Agenda 2030. Their whole agenda is, like Aaron Russo said, it's the chip, everyone. You know, that's the new world order. That's their new way of things. This is what lines up with the scriptures so that he can sit in power. Well, he can sit in the seat of the Most High. He wants to sit in the temple of the Most High. All right. Who is the temple of the Most High? The Israelites. He wants to sit in the seat of the Most High. He wants to be like the Most High. With the chip, man, he can determine where you at. He can GPS track you. Okay. He can control your funds. You can't get no under the table money because everything will be done digitally. How can you gonna get a job under the table, under the radar, so without being taxed? You know, it's become your new form of identity. All right. The way you buy and sell, man, it's, come on, man. What's wrong with you guys? This guy, he talking about us. Need to go look up. You need to go look up the word mark.
All right. Basically, the love of it.
Look, man, the love of it. Look, you guys that seek this attention, this is not the attention that you want. See, you want the attention from men of the Lord to do videos like this on you. We do it because it's edifying to those of the whole four elect, so that the newly fruit men, they'll know what's bad and what's good, man. That's all. You know, keep brothers on that straight path to righteousness, to salvation with Yahawah, Yahawashi. But you guys, you want this attention because you want to blow up. You want those views. See how he got 91 views? Because he put that link on Apostle Gabar's page. I had to give it a thumbs down, you know? And then you got three people that agree. You know, it's something else, man. You scoffers are something else. You don't sit on no type of principle. You don't have no standard. Like, I understand the hate that you have for Great Millstone. It's really because you hate the Lord. But here it is. Anybody that hates Great Millstone, they receive fans. It doesn't matter what it is that they're saying. They could completely be stupid, dumb, wrong. But a scoffer that know he dumb wrong would just agree with him anyway because it's against Great Millstone. That shows you how much you people hate the Lord, man. You know? How you get three? Get the hell out of here. This guy don't even know what he's talking about. You know? Then you got Tazariok from, that's the ISUPK. You know, he inviting any and everybody to Passover. That's another subject. But, man, the Lord got some house cleaning, man. This shit is crazy.
Worship of money, man, because that's the biggest idol, all right? That's the biggest idol in this world today is money, man, all right? Read what you got. Well, better.
He don't understand that the money is on the RFID microchip. Don't you know that we had a breaking point of the economy crashing? When the economy crashes because the money has crashed, all right? The money is not backed by gold. It has not the value in which they say it does, all right? When that shit crashed, you know, what's going to be the solution? You know, the chip. Why did FEMA, I forgot the number, Salakia, on my bad quote of the number, but I believe they purchased, I forgot, maybe about a million. I forgot the number, but they purchased RFID microchips. And I'm talking about FEMA. FEMA is a organization that helps in disasters. They come to your need. They're supposed to help in a time of need of a disaster, like a rainstorm or earthquakes. You know, they come and they're supposed to support, give out waters and shelter, refuge. You know, why did they purchase, I believe it was, what, 50,000 something microchips, man? You know, you could dig these things up, you know. But anyway, the RFID chip is the mark of the beast, man. I ain't playing no more of this shit. You know, enough. I think I said enough. So I hope you were edified. You know, don't follow after men. And these ain't nothing but niggas, man. You know, niggas in the hood that found, that watched the brothers. They learned a little bit. They got enlightened. Because I'm telling you, the word of the Lord is so powerful, man. when you first hear this truth and it resonate with you and you realize that you're an Israelite, man, you want to tell everybody, man. You know, but certain guys, they not of the elect, and the Lord did not call them. They find out they want to go out and mimic and be teachers. They want to be leaders. They seeing the apostles. They seeing the elders. They watching different camps, these other brothers and these men. And they got the videos and they cutting Edomites up and they sounding like they, you know, they got all this wisdom and knowledge. You know, these guys want to be a part of that. They want that, man. They want that. You know, in the ancient times, man, the prophets, you know, they didn't want to be no prophet, man. Now today, because of this camera and social media, everybody want to be a prophet. Why you think Jonah ran from being a prophet? Jonah was afraid of being put to death. Being a prophet is a high office, man. It's scary. You putting your life up on the line, man. You know? And these guys want to be teachers. Watch when Esau come in like a madman. You ain't gonna see no guy want to be no Israelite at all. They're gonna be denying the fact that he an Israelite. You're gonna be denying the fact. You ain't gonna want to be no teacher then. Telling you guys, you got people don't take this thing seriously, man. This is real deal, man. You know? Teachers of truth. Teachers of lies, man. Anyway, with that, want to give all praises to Yahawah, BaHaSham, Yahawashi, BaHaSham, Rawchaa, Qadash. Want to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the Lord's hopeful elect. Hopeful elect. Shalom.